To those on the outside, it was a happy picture. It was me, my mother, my father, and my sister. Everybody thought that we were the perfect family. All smiles and hugs, never been exposed to tragedy. My mother was the strongest role model in my life. She was the definition of the dedicated wife. My father didn't talk much, he'd watch and be silent. But behind closed doors, he was volatile and violent. And while his wife stayed in the house cooking and cleaning, he was out drinking for the entire evening. And when he found his way back, his demeanor was seething, subjected her to verbal and physical mistreatment. He was insecure and always thought that she was cheating. Made her feel like a weakling so she would never leave him. At nights when I should have been in bed sleeping, I was kept wide awake by the sound of her being beaten. There's not a single memory that I can hold dear. I'm stuck between grief and despair, shedding my tears. Every moment in this house is spent living in fear. They say home is where the heart is, but love has never lived here. There's not a single memory that I can hold dear. I'm stuck between grief in despair, shedding my tears. Every moment in this house is spent living in fear. They say home is where the heart is, but love has never lived here. I came home from school, saw her doing the chores. Tears were falling from her eyes and just hitting the floor. What I saw was a woman who was spiritually broken, stripped of her dignity, her pride and emotions. Her face was emblazoned with fresh cuts and bruises. And then I thought to myself, like, how could he do this? 'Cause this was supposed to be the woman he loved. And then the hate in my heart gave birth to a grudge. And behind contrived smiles, I could see that she was frightened, unsure of the future and seeking some enlightenment. And so I embraced her, and as my grip tightened, I made a promise to myself I'd never be like him. The gesture was complete when she kissed me on the cheek. We said so much, even though we didn't speak. And by then, I had decided in my mind that I'd seen my mother cry for the very last time. There's not a single memory that I can hold dear. I'm stuck between grief and despair, shedding my tears. Every moment in this house is spent living in fear. They say home is where the heart is, but love has never lived here. There's not a single memory that I can hold dear. I'm stuck between grief and despair, shedding my tears. Every moment in this house is spent living in fear. They say home is where the heart is, but love has never lived here. The following day, the same routine in the house. My father came home drunk, foaming at the mouth. He staggered through the passage and ended up in the kitchen. I was in the opposite room, waiting and listening. He approached my mother, he knew she was defenseless. She begged him not to do it, but he just beat her senseless. So then I made my entrance, knife in a clenched fist. From behind I grabbed him and repeatedly stabbed him. The years of abuse had finally taken their toll. I was calm even though I just lost control. I cut him so deep I felt the blade pierce his soul. I was covered in warm blood but mine felt cold. I looked at my mother and then the bloody weapon, then down at my father and watched as life left him. And there was no guilt or remorse to feel, 'cause the beginning of death was the end of our ordeal. There's not a single memory that I can hold dear. I'm stuck between grief and despair, shedding my tears. Every moment in this house is spent living in fear. They say home is where the heart is, but love has never lived here. There's not a single memory that I can hold dear. I'm stuck between grief and despair, shedding my tears. Every moment in this house is spent living in fear. They say home is where the heart is, but love has never lived here.